I will go ahead and officially call Rutabaga then. So okay. Rutabaga.
Rutabaga.
Are you ready?
Rutabaga.
Okay. So, hello there, folks. Cranky old Cuber here. You got to say your thing.
Oh, hi, I'm Cranky Dave.
Cranky Dave.
My thing is to not say my thing.
I know. Then I tell you to say right, the thing, and then you say the thing, and it's like it's they know this
and that's
now.
The thing.
They know how this works now.
We have things.
So, hey, we're here to just talk about some generic stuff. So it's possible that you will see this intro thrown in front of all kinds of different things.
Wait, I was told,
this is the generic
intro. I was told I was just here for pizza.
There'll be pizza. So, this generic intro could go in front of anything. You may see this intro 7, 8, 9 times because I'm lazy. So,
because he's lazy and he'll get it reused.
We just wanted to welcome you to the show and let you know that it's going to be a fun show. And so, but we have no idea what's going to come after this at all. So, speaking of Kit Clement. He was the WC delegate at the Spokane Valley Summer 2017 competition that we went to, and we had a chance to sit down with him and ask him a few questions about what it means to be a delegate and just basically how that happened, and, well, why don't we take a look?
Yeah, well, and we found out that being a delegate isn't necessarily a voluntary thing.
Definitely not. Yeah. Sometimes it just happens.
Sometimes you're just the one.
Yep. Let's watch our interview with Kit.
We just stepped all over the interview. I don't think anybody's interested in the interview anymore.
Nah, go ahead and watch.
We're all arguing about Babylon 5 now.
Kit's very interesting, so you should.
He's very interesting.
You should
pay
attention.
He's fun to talk to.
Definitely so.
Are they watching?
I think they're watching.
Well, you got to start it. You got to actually start it, or they won't watch it.
Oh, where's my remote? Wait.
I don't think this bit is working. Is this bit working?
All right. Are we here? Are we good?
Good to go.
Rutabaga is in effect, because I said earlier, Rutabaga
is always in effect.
All right. Hey, Cranky Old Cuber here.
I'm Cranky Dave.
And we are here with Kit Clement, who is the WCA delegate.
Not Clement. He hates that.
Yes. So, WCA delegate for the Spokane Valley Summer 2017 tournament that we're at.
He's the reason for the season.
And so, how does one become a delegate?
Very good question. Delegates are appointed generally by needs and by, if you're qualified, of course. So sometimes more one than the other, depending on the case. But
well, what is qualifying and what does qualified here mean?
So generally, delegates are people who should be able to advise someone on how to organize a competition. They should be a strong enough person to be able to make calls. You know, not a timid...
Right. They have to be willing to talk to people on the phone.
Yeah. You have to be willing and, you know, and know the regulations well enough to be able to make those kind of calls. So
you could actually suck at cubing and still be a delegate.
Oh, absolutely. Yeah.
Me too. Hey.
Except I hate people.
Well, we've been talking about organizing some meetups and maybe a competition out where we are.
That would be
kind
of cool. But I think there are plenty of delegates in the Puget Sound area considering the number of competitions that are out there.
Yes, but we want to have a cranky old competition.
Well, that's true. We need an old
cubing. It should be fun.
Yeah.
How long have you been a delegate?
Since November 2013.
Oh, that's a good one.
And how did that happen?
So, I was one of the more needs. Maybe I qualified. I don't know. But there were three. I lived in Michigan at the time. There were three delegates that kind of served the Midwestern area.
So where in Michigan?
You know.
My wife's from Detroit.
Okay. Yeah, I grew up in the Detroit area.
Okay.
Suburbs. Three delegates that existed at the time. We had Ilkew in Illinois. We had Mike Huey, another old guy in Indiana, and Jim Mertens in Ohio. And Jim Mertens was getting into his PhD program, kind of lost the time to really put into delegating.
Yeah.
Mike's kids were getting older, and he kind of started to lose the time to, you know, had too many other family commitments. And Ilkey was finishing his PhD and heading back to Korea. So kind of all at the same time, we were kind of going from three active delegates to zero.
So the crowd kind of cleared out, and you were just right there.
Yeah,
in the middle of the clearing.
There going.
Right. Yeah, actually, the first competition I delegated, I only knew I was going to be a delegate for it like 4 days before it happened. Because
how did you not wet your pants during the time?
It was fine. Ilkey was there, too. He was just like, he emailed
me. So you weren't flying blind.
Yeah, he only had like 3 days, 3 or 4 days before. He was like, "Hey, Kit, you want to delegate?" I was like, "Do I have to be a delegate to do that?" He's like, "Oh, that's a formality. We can get that covered."
Right. Well, seeing everything that you're doing at this competition, I'm impressed.
Well, thank you. Thank you.
Yeah, this looks like it's an involved job, so to me, anyway.
There's a lot of, I mean, to do a lot of, like, events in one competition, you do have to have, like, a decent amount of pre-planning, scheduling people in a way that, you know, is efficient, but also so that, like, you're not competing or scheduled to judge, like, back-to-back and have no time to warm up. I'm pretty sure everyone has, before any time they compete, some time to get warm-ups, time-solves in, so.
That would have been a good idea. Yeah.
That's what I did while I was waiting for you guys.
Uh-huh.
That's why you suck, because I actually warmed up.
Yeah. Maybe people should have warmed up for blind today.
No, well, everybody DNF'd blind today. Yeah, there is no podium for blind today.
Yeah,
if you'd taken 19 minutes and 59 seconds and got a solve, you would have been number one.
You would have been number one.
Yeah, I.
So do you get to keep the gift certificate now?
Oh, it just never gets handed out.
Oh,
cubicle laughs all the way to the bank.
So. Yeah. Oh, very nice.
Well, they do that anyway.
They're like, yeah, we'll give out $100 gift certificate for blind in these small ones because nobody's gonna win
the biggest one for blind. Yeah. And never give it out.
That's cool.
I mean, it's pretty rare. Caleb and I were actually wondering, like, how many comps with 9 or 10? Because I think we had 9 competitors in blind. It is not common for everyone to DNF all three.
Well, you know, I was your judge for the first one, and I saw how close you got, and that was just frustrating.
The reason I missed the first two was incredibly awful.
Yeah.
It's because, so I had a flipped edge in place, and when you're doing, like, you know, cycles and doing paths through, you have to actually notice the flipped edge, because when you're going from piece to piece, if there's a flipped edge.
Oh, and you just forgot the flip.
No, I just never saw it.
Oh.
I never saw it on solve one and two. There were flips on both of them, and I just never saw the flip on either. So, yikes.
Frustrating.
I think I saw both your first two.
Yeah, they were
And
bad.
That was just, and you were obviously frustrated. I would have been too.
Yeah, I
saw how close you got.
Well, and the worst part is my flip on the second, like the first one I really should have seen because it was the front UF edge that was flipped. I really should have seen that one. Second one, it was BD. So, because I told myself to have the first one, you got to check for that.
Right.
But I never saw it because I never actually turned around and looked at it.
But just to put it in perspective, you know, most people can't solve the cube. So blind solving in itself is a wondrous thing. It's like a miracle that happens. The fact that nobody got it, we got to keep that in perspective that this stuff is hard.
It's not easy. Yeah.
I mean, I know.
It's easier than you think it is.
It's easier than you think it is, but it's harder. It's harder
is
than
it
what
still working?
Did I just screw it up?
No. Okay. Good.
We're our own worst enemy when it comes to equipment here.
So we're actually tight on time, and I bet Kit wants to eat lunch.
Yeah, let's let him eat lunch.
Have you eaten lunch yet?
I'll get around to
okay.
it.
Okay.
I don't know. Well, you know, your blood sugar may crash and you may start killing people. Who knows?
Everybody is going to ask. They're going to ask in the comments, so I'm just going to go ahead and preemptively ask, what do you average on 3x3?
Who cares?
Who cares? There you go.
I probably, like... 3x3 is not an event I care about at all, but my PB average in comp is, I think, 13:10.
There you go.
What is the event you care about?
Fewest moves is my favorite.
So you competed this morning then?
Oh, yeah. I did really well, actually. Well,
excellent.
Really well enough to be very frustrating because...
Almost, but not there.
Well, so it was it's a best of one today.
And right.
Imagine, like, you go to a competition and they're doing a best of two round of 3x3 and you get a PB, you get, like, your two fastest times ever. Like on those first two solves, but you don't get an average, so you don't get a chance to get a PB average.
That's what happens because we
only did one attempt of FMC,
right.
I got a 22, and now I don't even get to use that for a mean. So
that's a good count. That's like two above God's number,
and
right?
It's not even my PB because I already had a 22.
Wow.
So it's like already, it's like, it was like laughing in my face, basically.
Okay. But still, 13 seconds for 3x3, that impresses us.
Yeah, it seriously impresses me. So,
I mean, come on, go look at my average and then understand, you know.
Yeah.
I beat him, that's all I'm happy about.
Yep. Yeah, Dave.
Trust me, you can get a lot faster. It's a matter of time. And
it's all in my F2L. My F2L just needs to improve. Greg beat me in 2x2 though.
We're not sure.
I'm pretty.
We haven't proven that yet.
I had like two fast ones and then three. Oh my God, what the hell am I doing here?
Yeah, but solves. I didn't have any fast ones. I had two okay ones and I had a slow
18,
one and I had.
I mean,
I
that's
a,
not fast.
I had a 17, an 18, a 22, a 20 something else, and a 27.
So I actually had one solve that was faster than any of yours.
Yes, you did.
I had an 11.
No, you had two solves that were faster than mine.
So I'm actually better than you.
Yeah,
okay.
I said.
Okay.
I said I don't think
you
won.
I will accept that.
Okay, good.
Is this still an interview?
No. Is it ever really an interview?
See, this is the best part. Is we're just like, hey,
this is what we do. This is the show.
Who's this guy? guy. We don't care.
Yeah. He looks pretty. Just put him in between.
Well, you're bantering with the rest of us. We're doing a good job.
So here's the deal. Lee wants pizza. I want pizza. You want pizza.
I want pizza. So we're going
to
go have pizza.
And we have to go judge Megamix. So,
yeah, that's true.
I do anyway.
Let's do
so.
That's true. He has to judge first, then me second.
So we will catch you later on, and we'll probably come back after we've judged some stuff, and we're also going to talk to Lee, who is the organizer of the tournament. So.
He's the reason. He's the other reason.
Odegaard? Yeah. Lee Odegaard?
Yep. Yeah,
Odegaard. Lee Odegaard. So look forward to that.
So yeah, that was a really good interview with Kit. We really enjoyed ourselves, and hopefully we'll get to keep doing stuff like that.
Well, I thought I was good, but I thought you weren't very good.
Oh no, I was great. Mm-hmm. I get a Tony for that.
A Tony?
A Tony.
Because this is on Broadway.
Yeah. Yeah. Ain't nobody giving me a Golden Globe.
Well, no.
What do you get? What do you get, a Webby?
For what?
I don't know.
A Tubi?
What's the... Oh, Darwin Award. That's the one I'm getting.
Yeah, that's a Darwin Award.
Good.
There you go.
Excellent. Right. Anyway, yeah, Kit, fun interview, nice guy.
Awesome.
Approved,
with moves.
Approved my claiming of my WCA ID, like, almost immediately, so
yep.
Absolutely good customer service, too.
To
what do you
use
think?
The term.
End of the show?
Well, we're asymptotically approaching
the end of the show. That's great.
We are experiencing Zeno's paradox in real life.
Zeno's paradox. That's the thing with the rubber band and the ant, right?
No, that's where you move halfway to the end, and then you move halfway to the end.
Oh, that's
halfway
right.
To the end.
There's a good
and you never get to
that.
The end because you only ever move halfway there.
There's a good engineer versus mathematician joke.
Well, of course, there's always paradox. Good. There's a whole boatload of engineer versus mathematician jokes.
I think we better end the show.
I think we've already lost everybody anyway,
right.
So there's really nobody to say bye to.
We'll end the show anyway.
All right.
Say bye, like we think there's people out there just
well,
in case, okay?
If there are, put them in the comments.
All right. Well, that is our show for this time, and we would like to thank you very much for watching the show, and we'll catch you at the next video. Cheers. Say cheers, Dave.
Cheers, Dave.
Okay, that's enough of that. What do you think?
Sure.
Okay, good.
I think you got plenty of stuff to not use.
You guys are ridiculous.
Okay. We did what?
Somebody keeps hitting the mic and I can't figure out who it is.
It's definitely, obviously, Dave. I mean, I wouldn't hit the mic.
Dave, punching mics makes audio engineers mad.
Well, there are a lot of things that make audio engineers mad.
Are you recentered?
Namaste, y'all.